I've been thinking about if I want to step in the circle before I actually perform tonight, and I think I'm actually going to do it just because there's going to be a lot going through my mind the moment that I go up there and play, and I don't want to like miss that moment that it happens. And I feel like there's something about like the circle's not scary. The circle's your friend, you know, and I feel like I should go up there and shake hands with the Opry.
It's kind of like being baptized in country or something, right? It's like this is the baptismal. Oh, man. All right, boom. Oh, that's awesome. Gosh. Oh, amazing. Feels amazing. Fits. This is awesome. Man.
Hey, this is Nate Smith, and this is my Opry debut.
Here. This is awesome.
We are getting ready to have me debut at the Grand Ole Opry, and I'm over the moon. My whole family's here, and try not to be too nervous.
Yeah, I don't really know what to say.
This is amazing. I was raised in a small town called Paradise, California. My mom was one of those first points of contact with music growing up, and honestly, like, she got me into country, 90s country, Alan Jackson, all that. And then my grandparents, they definitely like introduced me to more of the classic country. I started playing guitar at a young age, and I don't know how I convinced my dad to buy me a guitar, but he allowed me to do it, started writing songs, and just kind of really enjoyed music, found a love for it, became kind of my source of healing in a lot of ways. And everybody else was doing sports, and I was home picking on my guitar. My first move to Nashville, I was 23 years old. I had a record deal on the table, and I moved here, and ended up falling through. And I signed a publishing deal. So I wrote songs for about 3 years for other artists, but I went through a pretty tough breakup in my life, a personal relationship, and ended up coming back to California and kind of putting music on hold. I left Nashville really truly with my tail between my legs, like, I think I'm done. And, you know, I wouldn't say I like fully quit music, but I just wanted to do some other things for a while, you know. I tried to resist, but your kiss blew away. Our town of Paradise, California, while I was living there, ended up catching on fire. We've lost everything we've ever owned in our lives. A friend of mine sent me an acoustic guitar just to kind of help me heal and process. I wrote a song about the fire to bring a little bit of hope. Ended up connecting with the community. Started doing that again, started playing benefit shows, started doing concerts. All of a sudden, I'm like, holy crap, I'm playing shows, like, a lot. What's going on here? And ended up doing that full time up until the pandemic. For my debut today, what I hope to leave in the Opry circle is just a little bit of hope. My mom, my dad are here.
Where's mom and dad? Raise your hands. Ah, yes. Yes.
My sister, fiance, my aunt and uncle, all my closest friends have flown out. So it's gonna be one big party. It really means a lot to me. It really does. I couldn't do what I'm doing without people telling me you can do it, because I have a good support system around me. It's like, you're meant to be here. Remember your mission, you know, and a lot of prayers went into this, you know, truly, because there's been times in my life where I could have definitely gone this way or that way, you know, and we're here. So I want to make a difference. Yeah. And I think it's the Opry.
Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time at the Grand Ole Opry, welcome Nate Smith.
All right. Let's do this thing, huh?
Jeffrey! Down every painful memory fades away when I'm with you, yeah. And every high, every low, every late night drinking alone, swearing I will never love again. Baby, you got under my skin.
Thank you, Grand Ole Opry, for making my debut. Thank you, friends and family. Thank you so much, so much, so much. Mom and dad, my label, my management, love you guys so much. Thank you.